Many individuals are of the mindset that the key to wealth is hard work. Indeed, while hard work is needed, there is also a place for learning and knowledge. Many poor people lack money understanding, and even so, they don't care to learn, which is why they remain poor. In this video, I'll share with you 13 things poor people don't care to know about money. 1. You can't be rich by first acquiring frivolities. Most people in our society earn money to spend only. The first thing most people do when they make money is to give their money to the rich. A new phone, gadgets, a new television, etc. The poor spend first, and at the time they are done lavishing, nothing remains. On the other hand, the rich invest first and manage what remains. This way, they don't have much money to waste. Be wise. Looking rich is not the same thing as being rich. 2. Going to college does not equal being rich. College isn't the answer to financial freedom. It usually leaves you destitute if you're not careful enough to know what you need to know. The knowledge of wealth is not what you can get from school. You may have BSc, MSc, or even PhD in anything. That doesn't mean you know anything about money. College is not designed to teach you how to be rich. They are designed to teach you about your profession. Most cases, theoretical aspects. What you make out of the knowledge is solely dependent on you. You either decide to do the usual thing, get a job after school, and remain an employee forever, or you acquire the business and financial senses. 3. Having the someday mentality. This is when they see a pleasant home and they say, someday I'll be able to afford that home. With this mindset, you've separated yourself emotionally from owning that home, which means that you've assumed that your self-esteem is not there yet. Instead, affirm it to yourself that you already own it and work towards getting it. This habit of waiting for someday limits you substantially and keeps you from the ultimate good that has your name written all over it. Assume that you have all the things now and you'll have it sooner than you think. 4. Erroneous thinking. Many people have erroneous beliefs about money. Many false teachers have taught that having money is not right, leaving many people to feel guilty about becoming wealthy. This instigators jump to conclusions and assume that nearly all rich people are evil. Even if you desire to be wealthy, being in the company of these erroneous thinkers disrupts your money beliefs and makes you feel comfortable in your poverty, because you've begun to believe that if you are poor, you are humble and reasonable. 5. Savings are meant for investments. Many low individuals believe that if they are consistent with saving, they will be able to get their wants and needs later on. But this philosophy is not valid. You cannot meet up with your needs and wants by just saving. Besides, if you spend all the money you save on liabilities, what next? Do you start saving again? The only sure way to becoming wealthy is through investment. Poor people don't care to understand that saving is meant for assets, not liabilities. 6. Anybody can have money. To most people, only a few lucky people can have money and get rich or wealthy. They think if they don't hold a political office or inherit companies or are born into a wealthy family, they can't be rich. But that is a wrong perception. Not only wrong, but terrible. The truth is that even those born with silver spoons without the proper knowledge squander parents' wealth and end up broke and miserable, while individuals born as destitute later turn out to be wealthy. You don't have to be from a wealthy background to become rich. You can start from scratch. 7. There is as much money as you desire. One of the laws of money states that there is no shortage of money underneath the earth, only shortage of people who think correctly about money. How do you think about money? As long as you apply correct principles, the money will always come to you. But guess what? If someone else uses code better than you, the money goes to the person's direction. So, when you lose money, it's not like there is no money, it's just that someone did better and got the money. 8. The only thing you have in your hands is time. Time is money. Most poor people complain about 1,000 things they don't have and waste the only thing they ever need. That's funny. The only thing you ever need is time, and you have that already. Rich people respect the time they have and convert it to other things they want. Is it knowledge? You can recycle your time to learning. Is it a good relationship or experience? You can convert your time to that. If you want money, if you use your time right, you'll have more than enough. The level of respect you have for time determines how well you'll be able to use it to make money. 9. You can't be rich with one income. Wealthy people never depend on one flow of income. Instead, they create several revenue streams. They understand that your wealth is not the amount earned from one channel. It is the accumulation from different sources. The $1,000, $2,000, $3,000 that comes from other sources is what makes you a multimillionaire. If you think that you can be rich from doing that your old job over and over, you'd better wake up from your dream. 10. Saving by percentages. Even if you are terrible at arithmetic, learn to calculate percentages. A lot of individuals do not know how to calculate the rates, and so they base their savings on amounts. But the most effective way to save is to keep a particular percentage of your earnings, maybe 10 or 20%. That way, if your profit increases, your savings increase as well, without you being sentimental as to whether or not to increase the amount. For example, if you save 10% of your $100 salary, it means you save $10. So if your salary becomes $150, your savings automatically is $15. And you don't have to think about it, because in considering it, you might decide not to increase your savings at all. 11. Parents should teach money values. Most of our financial behavior starts with our parents. For example, what do you think the economic orientation that was always told that money lasts longer when it is managed will be? Almost every material possession that you buy tends to go through the parents' approval process. Most people do not purchase certain goods and services simply because they know their parents would never approve of it. However, this way of thinking can often become detrimental if it stops you from learning the truth about money. If you are a child who is told to spend less for the money to last more instead of making more money to get what you want, you will deprive yourself of your wants so that your money will last longer. 12. Wealth is a choice. It's your choice to be wealthy. No one can make that choice for you. However, most people have never made this decision, simply because they don't know that they can. The easiest way to decide is to accept that you want a particular lifestyle. Once you do that, you must develop goals which should also outline a plan of action for its attainment. The almost unbelievable truth is that if you have made that choice and set your mind on the goals, the universe has a way of supporting you and bringing everything you need your way. 13. You can't get rich working for someone. Yes, you would be average and comfortable, but you can be seen among the richest men, even in your community. If you check the list of the world's richest men, you will notice that almost, if not all of them, are entrepreneurs. Employees work to make their bosses rich. If you are aiming for real wealth, consider starting your own business. You may feel like you don't have enough money to start up, but do you know that the money the man used to start the company or the firm you're working for may not be as big as the one you used to buy your car? Making money is more about knowledge than it is about hard work. Else, the wealthiest individuals in the book would be the factory workers and other heavy-duty workers.